it's just the most frustrating thing in the world because you're like, I'm so close, but I never get the job, and I'm sick of it, and I'm like, I'm giving up. I've got $20 left in my bank account, I'm done. Like, I'm done with LA, my dream is over to be an actor, I'm going back home, and I'm going to get a real job, and I'm just going to get stuck in the world again. And then I call my mom, and I'm like, I need to get some money to get home because I've got no money, I need, like, you know, can I borrow some money from family or friends just to get a flight home? Then I get a phone call, and it's my agent, he says, you've got a job. And I was like, well, that's impossible. How can I have a job? I haven't auditioned for anything this week. He's like, well, Vampire Diaries has offered you a job. Now, the thing was, I tested for Stefan. So it came down to me and Paul Wesley for Stefan. So they knew who I was. And then other auditions had come up during the time, and they always were interested, but nothing ever happened. So they felt like, we know Nathaniel, we like Nathaniel, we're just going to give him a job. So I get this job. And at that point, I'm still, yes, this is all about my career, and this is amazing, and this is going to be the start of a career that's going to be so good for me. It's my first job in the US. So I get to Atlanta, and my first night in Atlanta, I'm on Facebook, and I'm just like typing away, and my friend that, you know, that watched these DVDs with me 3 years earlier, I hadn't seen him for like a year and a half, he goes, hey man, what's going on? And I'm like, oh, I got a job, I'm in Atlanta, I start in a week, you know, and he's like, you're in Atlanta? And I'm like, yeah. He's like, do you remember those DVDs we watched of that preacher that you loved? I was like, yeah. He's like, he's got a church in Atlanta. So I was like, all right, well, if it's close, you know, because I was still sort of living in the world. Anyway, it turned out to be 10 minutes from my hotel. So I went to this church. I went by myself. And I was so awkward in this church by myself that I brought my camera with me. So I'm sitting in this church, and I've got my camera, so it looks like I've got something to do. And this girl comes up to me, she's like, you're not allowed to take photos, I'm really, really sorry. And I'm like, oh, no, I'm not taking photos, I'm just by myself, blah, blah, blah. And we get to talking, she's like, oh, you're Australian, you can't be sitting by yourself. So she sits me with these friends. I hear this guy talk, and he's incredible. And it's so amazing. And then I keep going to this church, and he's just talking about like this love of Christ, and he's talking about how it's such a redeeming thing, and the world is so corrupt, so broken, but there is something bigger than it, you know? So, you know, I've just been inspired by this guy. The very last message that I saw him speak was basically, what comes first in your life? Like, what's the most important thing in your life? Because God gives us passions in life. There's nothing wrong with that. He wants us to be good at what we do. But if God isn't first, then you're not living that life. And it's the first two big commandments is what Jesus said. Is the first commandment is love your God with all your heart, all your mind, and all your soul. And then the second commandment is love your neighbor. That's all he said. Two big commandments. So that's when I changed my life. And I said, that's it. God comes first before everything. So what the crazy thing is, I really, really, really want to meet this preacher because he changed my life. He changed everything about my life and everything that I'm doing to this day. But it was impossible to meet him because it was like a 4,000 person church. So like, there's no chance I'm going to meet this guy. My very last episode of season 3 was on a Thursday. I finished the episode, and Vampire Diaries was like, okay, you have to go back home, you're done. And I was like, okay, cool. And then something got put on my heart to stay another weekend to go to church one more time. So I stay, I pay my own way, I get a hotel, and then I get a phone call from the girl that came up to me the very, very first time and said, you can't take photos. And she said, hey, we're going to go to Disney World in Florida. Do you want to come with us? This is a